How long would you expect your kitchen blender to last? 10 years? 5 years? 1 year? And what happens when it inevitably blends its last smoothie? Is it going to be fixable? Today we're going to tear down a cheap blender made by Walmart's white label brand Mainstay, an entry level blender by popular household appliance maker Shark Ninja, and an open source challenger seeking the blender repairability crown, the OpenFunk Remix. Now you've probably heard of the first two, but the OpenFunk Remix blender is a modular, repairable kitchen blender designed to work with your own glass jars and built from recycled, locally made parts in Berlin to reduce waste and challenge the throwaway culture of conventional appliances. But we'll get to that in a minute. Let's start with the cheapest blender in our lineup. At $30, the white label Mainstay by Walmart is by far the cheapest of the blenders in our lineup. So let's take a look inside. The screws holding the base together are underneath four rubber feet that come away easily enough. Once the screws are out, the base folds back and reveals the motor and button board. But then, there's not much more to do here, other than to remove the motor, which means removing these three screws, securing the motor to the plastic body. The buttons are wired directly to various points on the motor, so the easiest thing to do is to dismantle the button board and remove everything together. To release the motor shaft, the motor gear needs to be removed by turning it clockwise by hand. With the motor shaft freed, I can remove the contents of the base in one go. Top marks for simplicity, but that's all this device gets. Whatever might break in here, you're going to be on your own for replacement parts, as Walmart does not offer anything resembling a repairable ecosystem for their product. In fact, if you look at the reviews, it's full of people complaining about burnt out motors, which you probably won't be able to find. If the motor works but the blades don't spin, you might be able to fix it by cleaning the blade, or find a compatible blade from another blender. The $130 Ninja Professional Plus with Auto IQ is in the middle of our triple blender teardown slushy. The Ninja opens through the bottom as well, but as is typical for Shark Ninja products, the screws are Torx security. That means there is a single pin in the center of the screw that prevents regular Torx from engaging with the screw. Needless to say, this is an unnecessarily repair hostile choice on Ninja's part. That initial layer was basically just a cowl. There's another four screws under here, this time the mighty Phillips, followed by a single screw securing the power cable. With the base layer away, I can see the motor, and in place of a button board, there's a complex looking circuit board. Evidently, this level of complexity is needed to enable the three presets offered by the Auto IQ model. That comes at the cost of simplicity and repairability. Fixing analog controls will be an order of magnitude easier than replacing an IC on this board. To add to my teardown woes, every bulky wire is soldered back to the motor. For the sake of comparison with our other devices, I'm not going to desolder these cables to see how far I can get. The answer is not very far at all. Like the other blender, as best as I can tell, the motor gear needs to turn clockwise. I tried, as did my cameraman, but regardless of how much force we applied, that gear wouldn't budge. So here ends this teardown. Whatever their thought process was, Shark Ninja's design team clearly thinks that these gears need to be tightened to an ungodly torque. Not that it matters at all, because when it comes to repair, your options are whittled down to a replacement base, which costs as much as the whole unit. Then there's some spare parts in the shape of blender blades and replacement jugs, but nothing resembling a full repair ecosystem that includes manuals or base unit components. Last up is the new kit on the block and the most expensive blender in our lineup at €350, OpenFunk's Remix. Right off the bat, this blender offers something that I find incredibly appealing, a blender head threaded for compatibility with mason jars. Finally, a cheap way to replace a broken pitcher. Now, that boxy design isn't going to be to everyone's taste, but personally, I love it. It's a subtle hint at the accessible, repairable, and highly modifiable design hidden underneath. Let's open it up and take a look. The front panel houses four Torx screws, and the dial knob is held in place by a recessed flathead screw. Once the front plate is lifted back, I can tackle the two screws wired to the dial mechanism. Next, I'm going to remove the blender head by giving it a gentle twist. This reveals the motor gear, which I'll come back to in a second. Turning the blender over, I can remove the four Torx screws on the back panel, which comes away. Now that both the front and back panels are out, I can remove the slotted side panels and set them aside. By the way, if the panels aren't to your liking, you can visit OpenFunk's GitHub page and download STL files to print your own. That kind of customizability isn't something you'll find in any other blender. I need to get the wiring released, so next up I have to tackle the safety switch mounted on the side. This switch keeps the circuits in an open state until a jar is attached to the blender head. It's a safety mechanism. At this point, I can separate the bottom half of the base from the top half with the motor attached. I want to show you something else that's really cool, and for that, I need to remove the plastic housing on the base plate. Take a closer look. This part, along with several others, are 3D printed and you can download the STL files directly from OpenFunk's GitHub page. You can even find CNC files for various milled components. Alright, let's get back to that base plate and remove the ventilation grid so I can route the plug through and free it. This will make the rest of the disassembly a bit easier for me. I want to remove the motor from the top plate now, and that means removing 4 long torque screws and removing the motor gear itself. As with most blenders, these gears usually need to be turned clockwise to unscrew. And with that, the motor is free from the body. From here, there are a couple of other minor components that can be dismantled, like the power cable, but the single largest component left is the motor itself, which is replaced as a single unit. OpenFunk's GitHub page not only has CAD files for repairs and mods, it also houses a full assembly manual and bill of materials, detailing the manufacturer and part numbers needed for any kind of repair or replacement. That degree of transparency is basically unheard of, but so important for making a product that's future-proof. You don't have to rely on OpenFunk staying solvent for this blender to stay repairable. Which makes this the holy grail of repairable blenders. It looks simple, doesn't it? But I promise you, design for repairability isn't immediately obvious. From what I've seen here, we're looking at two very different design philosophies. For the end user, it's not just the upfront cost, but a decision to be made as to whether you want to own your hardware or rent it until it breaks. The lower end of the scale, represented by Walmart's mainstay, is the worst of the worst, lacking durability or repairability, resulting in a device that's going to be a temporary addition to any kitchen before it ends up in a landfill. SharkNinja's design is a step up, but still falls within the disposable category due to its blatantly repair-hostile design and lack of a user-serviceable repair ecosystem. I'd place this device in the long-term rent and dispose category. The mainstay blender isn't covered by US right to repair laws because it doesn't contain any electronic components. SharkNinja, on the other hand, are taking advantage of our least favorite right to repair loophole. By offering replacements instead of repairs within the warranty period, they're able to make unrepairable disposable products. As for the OpenFunk Remix, it's clearly the winner both in repairability and longevity. It's got all the repair bells and whistles, 3D printable parts thanks to CAD files, a full bill of materials, and a repair manual that completes the repairability ecosystem for this product. This thing will last as long as you want to keep it running. The small team behind this product deserves praise and support. Really well done.